Welcome to our next segment of Handy Andy on Bethel Park TV Cable. Fun show today. We're going to be the world of glues. We're just talking all about glues. So from wood glues to epoxy glues, from Duco cement to super glues to seam glues to wood chair glues to everything there is about glues. So we got a couple things to show. If these things break, you use this thing. So we're just talking all about glues. And people break everything in their house. And most people are just familiar with your basic everyday super glues and crazy glues. But we want to show you that there's a lot of more glues out there. This is really even just a sampling of the glues that I have. But there's a lot of glues that are better for doing certain things than super glues. So don't just rely on the basic everyday super glues. They work on some things. They don't work on everything. But you know, starting with super glue, the way the super glues work is super glues actually mix with the oxygen that's in the air. And when you open up a tube of super glue and put it on, it's the oxygen that's causing it to harden and harden very quickly in most cases. But with using super glue, the surfaces have to be non-porous type surfaces. So that's why there's better glues to use depending on what you're working with. So basic coffee mug. Say you got a coffee mug and the handle is broken off on the coffee mug. A lot of people are just going to take super glue, put a couple dabs on it, and hope it holds. Sometimes it does, sometimes it doesn't. A better glue would be a glue called Duco cement. Duco cement is a type of glue that is designed just for china, just for porcelain. So this handle breaks, you use a couple dabs of the Duco cement, and because of how porous the material is with these handles, your Duco cement is absorbed into the porousness of it, and it gives you a lot larger bonding surface area than what your regular super glues would. And that's why on china plates, on china cups, on porcelain products, vase, plates, anything like that, having a can of Duco cement or a bottle of Duco cement around is going to work a lot better than just your basic type of super glues. Couple other specialty things that we'll talk about. This is a piece off a lawnmower engine. This is part of the air filter going into carburetor. A lot of times people will break a piece of plastic and so forth off of it. So gluing it on, once again, some people might just try super glue to glue it on. The trouble with this is this has a lot of dirt, grease, oil, gasoline in particular, and you use your super glue type of products on that, the solvents in the gasoline particles are going to dissolve the glue and it may bond quickly, but it's not going to adhere to it. In those kind of instances, I like to use epoxies. And with the epoxies, there's a lot of different brands of epoxies. JB Weld is a very good one. You get into products like PC7. The one thing to realize with any of your epoxies, whether it's the syringe epoxies, the tube epoxies, these are little squeeze tube type epoxies. On any of your epoxy type of products, what you have to do is you have to mix equal portions. You have a part A and a part B. So you get a little piece of paper, you squirt out the different parts of it. So whether it's the DevCon, whether it's this quick gel, or on these syringe type ones, they're a little bit more consumer friendly to use. You're just breaking off the bottom, you squeeze out the glue like a big syringe, and then put it on a paper plate or a piece of paper, something that you're going to throw out afterwards. Have a little Q-tip or a piece of popsicle stick or a little piece of a paint stick, and you have to mix the two components together. Once you get them mixed, then you find the spot that you're going to apply it to, whether on this instance it's going to be on these little tabs. You're pushing your plastic together, and the epoxy type glues are a lot stronger. I'm talking 50 to 100 times stronger than what your super glue type of products are. When your epoxies harden, there's not much that would be able to destroy them. You'd be able to break this plastic, but you wouldn't be able to break the welds, the bonds that the epoxies do make. Also with these epoxies, they are gas oil material resistant. I'm a fan of the JB Weld JB Weld comes in two different types. One they call a quick weld, and one is a slower curing weld. If you're doing something that you want more of an instant type bond, that's when you use the fast setting ones. I like the slower setting when you can, because that way if you're trying to position them around, you don't have to worry that the product is drying too quickly. You have your time to position, maybe wipe off the excess. It gives you a little bit more control of the product itself. But on the same aspect of it, if you need something that's a very, very fast dry, because it's going to fall apart and you just can't sit there and hold it that long, that's when we use a product like a JB Quick Weld or in any of these other type of epoxy syringes. This one here from Devcon is a 5-minute type of cure. So once again, like the Quick Weld, it's going to cure up and harden in 5 minutes. A 2-ton one, this is going to be a stronger epoxy, but it's a slower setting. So you pick and choose what product you need for the job, depending on what you're doing. On that carburetor part, that air filter part, on this part, I would be using a slower setting because I'm able to have it apart. I'm able to put the pieces together and I'm able to let it set up slowly. I'm not looking at something instantaneous on it. And it's the same thing. Say you're working with a piece of pipe or something, the epoxies are going to give you a lot better strong excess, especially when you have something this hardened of a steel. So we're putting a couple pieces of steel together. Once again, I'd be using picking one of the epoxy type products to do it. Now, along with the glues, what you have to realize if you're using the slower fast setter, a lot of times clamps come into play. So we're not just going to talk about all the glues. We're talking about devices that you can use to actually hold things together. So even the coffee mug, a piece of pipe, the carburetor, something, there's different clamps that you can use to make the job easier. These spring type clamps are very quick, simple, easy. They have a release tab on it where you're just pushing the tab, open it up, and then it's just a small ratchet. So depending on what you're trying to bond, what you're trying to hold, you could sit there and tighten it up on it, and you can make it as loose or as tight as you want, depending on the surface and the strength and so forth of the clamp itself. So keep in mind when we're using and working with the glues, have a clamp or two around. It's going to make your life easy on it. And then this is just a little bar clamp, you know, same type of deal where you're just ratcheting it down, or you could sit and pull the tab up and release it and open them back up on it. You know, the bar will open back up with just the quick release tab on it. Now, along with the steel, we have wood products. So whether you're gluing a couple pieces of wood together, or we have even a little sliver of a wood that came off and you want to glue just the little piece of sliver back together on it. With wood glues, once again, your super glues, they're not going to work on the woods because wood is too porous, and you put super glue on a piece of wood, all it's going to do is it's going to soak into the porousness, the open pores in that of the wood. It's not going to leave any surface area for the glue to bond two surfaces together. So what we have is we have a lot of different type of wood glues on it. And whether you're familiar with a weld bond, we got Elmer's, we got some contact cement, and we have some Gorilla Glue. Gorilla Glue is a urethane-based glue. So on any of your Gorilla Glue type of products, thinking Gorilla, thinking super strong, you're right. You know, using a product like a regular a yellow type glue, like a weld bond compared to a Gorilla Glue, the Gorilla Glue is going to be a lot stronger. The dilemma, or not dilemmas, but the differences between it, they're both a slow setting type of glue. Anytime we're working with wood, we generally want a slower setting because as you're piecing things together, you want to give it time to work on it. This yellow type glue dries more to a clear type finish, and it's easy to wipe off the excess. It's not as strong, so if you don't need something that is super, super strong, I like using the regular yellow glues, whether it's with the tight bond or whether it's with the Elmer's type wood glues. But in the urethane glues you see in this bottle, Elmer's makes a urethane glue. It's a kind of a goldish, yellowy type of color. When you're using these, whether it's Gorilla Glue or the Elmer's urethane glue, this product foams a lot. So as you're using it, you have to be careful. You use a lot less of the glue, but because it's a urethane base, it's going to foam up a lot as you're using it and as you're drying it. So as you're foaming, it's going to ooze out of all the seams, and you have to be careful with it because you can get it on surfaces that it's not going to come back on. And it's a little harder to stain over top of a urethane glue, where if you're using the yellow glues, it's a lot easier to stain, and you're doing woodwork. A lot of times you're putting a walnut or an oak or a mahogany color over top of the wood. The yellow glues take the stains a lot better than what a urethane does. So as this dries, it oozes, it foams, and you have to sometimes actually take a knife or a scraper and cut all the excess glue off of it after it starts curing. Then you're sanding it smooth and you're hoping to stain it. If you're painting it, it's going to be a lot easier using the Gorilla Glues. But once again, if we were going to be gluing this and we would be putting it back on and putting the glue into it, you'd want to get some kind of a clamp system, whether it's the smaller ones, the bigger ones, and you want to put it on. These are a little harder because they're harder to control. You get one of these type of clamps, you can do a lot easier of having them clamp down and having them hold without falling off on it, because you could be a lot gentler with your touch and it's going to hold everything together for it. So using this clamp, having it put on the glue and having the clamp, and then this could sit for a day until, whether it's the urethane or the yellow type of glues, then that's going to dry without you having to stand there and hold it for half a day or something on it. So that's why having the clamps going to be a lot easier on doing your jobs with what you're doing with it, and then just release it when it's done and take it apart. Now, if we were gluing two larger pieces together, then these type of clamps are a lot quicker. They're just sitting there holding it on, and that clamp is not going to move whatsoever until you release the tab on it and pop them back off again. So these are more of a ratchet, a spring type clamp, small, large, whatever, but you know, your pressure on it is going to be doing it. On these type of clamps, everything is in the pressure. These have a very large spring down on the back side of the clamps itself, so there's no ratcheting or anything on it. These springs are just ones that, you know, hold on and clamp and be done. They're maybe a little bit quicker, but they're actually a little harder. So if you're working with a softer surface area, a clamp like this could indent the surface, where a clamp like these, it's all in how tight you tighten it down, whether you want it to make an indent or not make an indent on it. So knowing the clamps, knowing what the clamps do, is going to help you in picking the right products. Now what I'd like to show you is some of the specialty glues and explain what they're for. So if you have any of those special type products out there, this here, this is for tightening spokes in chairs and tables. You have all those wood legs, you have the spiral slats to the back of a chair, and a lot of times they come loose because they were just glued in at the factory. The factory would use just a regular yellow type glue, but over the years that glue starts working free on it. There's a very, very simple way to put these in, and with the wood slat, you just have the slat that has come out of the hole, or the little round railing, the dowel rods and so forth, or you have a leg that came off on it. You're turning the chair over and you want to fix a leg on it. You just fill a little bit of the cavity where that leg came out, put this in, and this liquid is more than just a glue. What this does, it is actually permanently swells the wood. So as this cures in the wood, it's soaked into the porousness of the wood, and you're not relying on just the glue holding the spokes or the spindles back in like you would with a Gorilla Glue or a yellow glue. This actually is swelling the wood, so you're not relying on just an adhesive holding it together. It makes the wood spokes swell up, so they're going to hold into the other ends of the wood very, very well, because you just can't pull them apart again. You got starting small, it swells, gets larger, and you can't pull them back out again. Then we have products like Seamzol. Seamzol is a very good gas oil resistant one part component type of glue. So if we're doing some gasket repairs on an engine, on a carburetor or something where it's in direct in contact with the gas and oils, it's a great product for helping in repairing any of those type of seals. And when we're doing building again, there's products for holding bolts together. A lot of times you have a nut and a bolt and you're trying to put the nut on the bolt and those nuts keep falling off, whether they're on your lawnmower wheel or on your stroller or on a wagon or something. And these parts, the nut keeps coming off of the bolt and you're losing them, constantly having to buy them. This is a product called a thread lock. You would put this and smear it around the male end of the threads on the bolt itself. You tighten the nut back onto it, and what it does is it bonds that nut to that bolt so it can't easily come back off again. It's not going to fall off by itself. But it's not like you're using epoxy and you're gluing them together, because a lot of times down the road you will need to take that nut back off of the bolt, whether you're changing the wheel or fixing the wagon or fixing the baby stroller. You want to be able to, with a wrench, take those nuts and back off again to take it apart to do other kind of repairs. So use a product like a thread locker. It's going to hold the nuts and bolts together, but in time you would be able to loosen them to take them back off and repair them again. Now also in the epoxies, one thing I should have mentioned, products like this, the PC7, PC11, these have been one of the very first products out on the market on it. Difference being is this is a special one that it dries white, where most of your epoxies dry black or gray. And so if you need something white, you're fixing a porcelain toilet, that'd be a great, great product for fixing a porcelain toilet, but it'll dry white instead of drying to all those harder type of colors. Doing something like in your gutters, if you're just working on thin metal type products and you have a pinhole or a crack or something or a seam in your gutter, and you want to get up there and seal that type of seam, a product like this is a metal patch, it's called, and you can just put this on and it fuses two thinner pieces of metal together. This isn't designed for, you know, like trying to fuse together big, thick, heavy pipe where you'd want to use the epoxies. This would be for thinner sheet metal. So you have a gutter seam, you want to fill that gutter together, or you have two paper thin pieces of metal and you want to fuse them together. A product like this is going to be absolutely perfect for it. Contact cement. Contact cement is for a large flat area. Say you're repairing a countertop and you're putting Formica back down. What contact cement does, like the name says, it bonds on contact. So you have two surfaces of it. Say, you know, this is a countertop and we're putting more Formica on it. You put the contact cement on both surfaces. You let them get tacky so you can feel them. Just stick your little finger in them and you could feel them getting tacky. And then what you do is once you put the two surfaces together, they bond on contact. So when we're using large areas where you don't have the wherewithal to use clamps or something on it, and you want them to bond very, very quickly because of such large sheets, say your countertop is 4 feet by 8 feet or something, that's when you're taking them, you're positioning them on a sheet that big, someone would help you, and as you're dropping the surface area down, it's going to bond on contact for you. Specialty product, shoe goo. You have tennis shoes. A lot of people wear out tennis shoes just on the bottom soles before the shoes wear out. This is a rubber compound made to rebuild the soles of shoes. A lot of people love it for doing tennis shoes in particular because they seem to wear out so quickly. You have just a back corner or the front corner or something of that shoe that is worn out. You could take the shoe goo and you could build the surface area back up. It bonds super well to those rubber type of surfaces, let it dry overnight, and you could have formed it to where that shoe is usable again. You don't have any hole in the bottom of that shoe anymore. Then we get into products like liquid nail and all-purpose cements. These are construction adhesives. Whether you're putting two pieces of big wood together, You're trying to bond 2x4s or other rafter boards or something where your small wood glues and Gorilla Glues aren't really realistic because it'd just be way too expensive on it. You can use products like Liquid Nail. These are small squeeze tubes, or you can get them in the 10-ounce tubes, the 30-ounce tubes, depending on what you're doing. So these are more of what I call construction type adhesives, not for the little jobs around the home, but the big jobs around the home or on construction sites. You can actually bond a brick to wood, you can bond bricks to brick, and you can actually use Liquid Nail, where this is a made by DAP. This is called Beats Nail. It's just another brand from the Liquid Nail brand itself. And what you're doing with these is you can use this actually as a contact cement. So if you have two surface areas and you have a garage wall and you want to bond a 2x4 to it without having to use screws, nails, power drills, and fasteners, you can coat a surface area of that block wall. You can coat another surface area of the wood with the Liquid Nail. Let them sit for 15, 20 minutes until you see them starting to dry out and get tacky. Put the boards up onto the block wall, and it's going to bond on contact for it. You still have to let it cure for a good 6-8 hours, but the glue itself is going to hold the two surface areas together without having to use screws and nails and heavy clamps and so forth with it. So whether you're doing the epoxies, the super glue, the Duco cement, there's a job for everything. Here's one, vinyl fabrics. This is one, say you have your car seat, say you have an umbrella, say you have rubber boots. This is a product that works very, very well in any of those flexible type areas. And that's the problem with car seats, leather seats, or umbrellas. Those surface areas are very, very flexible. They give a lot. You need an adhesive that's going to give with it. So if the seat in your car has split, you could put this vinyl repair on it, let it cure overnight, and then as you're sitting on it, the glue is actually going to flex when the two surface areas flex from the weight of you on it or on your rubber boots, your galoshes that you're putting on. You want to be able to have it give as you're using the product. And that's where a product like this one would come into place. So mason jars and so forth. A lot of times you'll get a crack and so forth in this. Once again, that would go back to the Duco cement, which works very, very well on the porousness of the glass type of products. But with the glass compared to porcelain, actual glass is a little bit coarser, so you would be able to actually try for once using something like a super glue. But for me, super glue is more of like, say you have a small piece of jewelry, or you have, you know, a little toy, piece of toy or something that broke off, that it's not heavily abused, the surface area is a little harder area. That's where I pick up and use some of these super glue type of products. So hopefully you learned something today. There's a lot of different glues here, but you know, when in doubt, stop down at the hardware store and ask, and we could go through it. Just tell us what it is that you're fixing, and we're going to be able to recommend whether you're using the epoxies, the Gorilla Glues, the weld bonds, the fabric adhesives. You know, just in case I forgot, the weld bond. What I use weld bond for is I actually use this as a glue additive. This is an all-purpose type of glue. I can glue wood with it. I can glue brick and block with it. But actually, if I'm mixing cement and I want to add some extra glue to that cement as I'm applying it, so an old piece of cement sticking to a new piece of cement, I'll take some weld bond and I'll mix it with the wet cement before I add it to the surface area, the sidewalk or the driveway, and it adds strength to the concrete. So the new concrete bonds to the old concrete. So like I was saying, you tell us what your project is. We'll fix you up with the right type of glues and the right type of clamps. So instead of just super gluing everything that sometimes works, sometimes doesn't work, picking the right glue for the right job, it's going to make the job go easier, and it's going to get it done right the first time. So you don't have to constantly be redoing it and retrying it and breaking it more than fixing it the first time. So I like to do things right the first time. So pick the right glue and do it right the first time. So appreciate you watching our segment on Handy Andy on Bethel Park TV Cable. and be looking for another segment soon. Thank you. Andy Amrine, EV True Value Hardware, with the Bethel Park Volunteer Scholarship Fund. This prize here that my fellow producers and I are standing behind is a Weber SP310 stainless steel propane barbecue grill.
We have the greatest stainless steel Weber grill in history. Come buy these $1 tickets right now.
These tickets are available now at multiple Bethel Park locations.
Tickets are available every day, 7 days a week at EV True Value Hardware.
Here at the front desk at the library.
Tickets are also available at BP TV's offices during regular office hours. If the lights are on, come on in. We're friendly. We promise. We'll sell you tickets. Who's doing that?
You heard the locations. I am a location. Come and see me or out in the streets. On my show, you get the talking machine going with buying $1 tickets everywhere.
Mayor Allen will pull the winning ticket during the regular council meeting on Monday, June 8th, live on BP TV.
Thank you for supporting the Bethel Park Volunteer Scholarship Fund. Buy your tickets today.
Or else.